It is so full. I didn't even think one second that I could use up this much makeup in a year. It's falling. Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to do an exciting video. I have waited all year to do this. Even though it is 2020, I have waited all of 2019 to get to this point where I can show you what I used up in a year, makeup wise. This is so insane. I have used up so much product and much more than I have ever thought I would. So let's see how long this video is going to be. Grab a snack, cup of tea, whatever you want to drink. I think we are going to be here for a while. I will not go into details about these items because I have talked about them all in my empty series that I have done whole year. I do them almost every month. So I will leave the playlist down below so you can watch me go through in depth about these products. Most of them I will not buy again, and some of them I will buy again. Depends on the cruelty-free status and if I liked it overall. I will put here on the screen what I finished up in total, because right now I don't have an overview and I can't remember what I used up last year. So there will be a tally here on the side, maybe this side, whatever I want to do. But you can see the totals on the screen. I just know I used up a lot this year. I think I used up more this year than last year. So let me just show you my primers. And there's a lot. Oh my god, I used up a lot of primer. I used up 6 primers. 6. Oh my goodness. And only one of them I'm using while I'm panning another one. So this is just insane. So the first one that I'm going to buy again and that I have used all every day, all year, while I have been panning the other ones I'm going to talk about, it is the W7 Perfection Pore Minimizer. And I love this product so much and I will keep buying this because this works and it is cheap and I love it so much. This primer is also a kind of a serum product. It is the W7 Princess Potion Complexion Booster and Primer. I used it as a serum because as a primer it was just too greasy, so really excited to have this done. Used up the Makeup Revolution Star Primer. It is a water gel primer. It was a blue one. It was really nice, but my skin broke out when using this. So I used up 2 of the Max Factor Facefinity All Day Primer. And I'm really excited about this not being cruelty free because this is my favorite primer. I actually think it is discontinued. So it is my holy grail primer that you can't get anymore. So that is really sad and it's not cruelty free. I'm really sad about it. I have a whole video on that. Comparing it to this primer. This is the CoverGirl Outlast All Day Primer and Base. Oh my god. This I can get a hold of, kind of. It is only in the States though. Canada, whatever. Not in Europe. I'm really sad about it, but I need to just seek out with other primers. I can't. I love this primer so much and I will buy it again if I could. I used up 3 foundations. This is separating and this is really gross. Oh my god. So they are all from W7. If you're new here, I was an ambassador for W7, so that is why I have so much of that brand. This is the W7. It's a matte made in heaven, heavenly matte foundation. I'm so glad this is the last time I'm going to say that name because that is insanely long for a foundation. It is a beautiful foundation, but I'm not going to buy it again. Because it's not my favorite at all. My favorite though is the W7 HD foundation. This one is amazing. It has a satin finish, so you can use all powders with it, all concealers with it, primers, whatever. It is a beautiful foundation and it actually comes in a light enough color for me to wear all year. So that is amazing. Another one that I'm also panning at the moment and I have bought a new of because I wanted a mixer and this was light enough for a mixer for the other foundation that I'm panning. It is a W7 Face Fantasy Matte Finish Foundation. This one right here. And this is better than this matte foundation. And it is also lighter. And it has a better shade range. So I will definitely buy this one over the matte made in heaven. those were the three foundations that I finished this year, and I finished four concealers. The first one I have is my Maybelline Fit Me concealer. I have used up so many of these, and I'm really sad this is not cruelty free, because it actually has a really light shade now, which would be perfect for me in the winter time, but because I went cruelty free, I cannot buy that again. We have the Maybelline Instant Anti-Age Rewind, or the Eraser Eye. Is it called both? I don't know. This one. You all know it if you are a YouTube fanatic. This is a really, really nice concealer. I really love it. I have went through two of them. But yeah, not cruelty free, so I'm not going to buy it again. Two that is so alike is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define Concealer. I already have a new one of this one. I love it. And then the Gush Concealer High Coverage. I really like this concealer as well. But it has a little bit more product in it than the Revolution one. But the Revolution Concealer is definitely more inexpensive, more cheaper than this one. This one is really, really nice though. Powders. I have used up 3 pressed ones and 2 loose ones. I'm really impressed. 2 of them are my Holy Grail Under Eyes Setting Powder. It is the Essence All About Matte Fixing Compact Powder. Yes, I love this primer. I don't have another one. I want another one though. I really do. I used up the pressed version and the loose version of the W7 Set It Up Powder. Really love this. I like the loose one better than the pressed one though. And then we have the W7 Matte Dreamer Loose Powder. I really enjoyed this as well. I actually did. I'm not a loose powder person, but after this year, I definitely became one. I have the Rimmel London Insta Fix and Go 2-in-1 Primer and Setting Spray. Not cruelty free, but I don't really like it that much. It doesn't do that much for me, I think. I have 2 sponges, and yes, I do count them in my empties because I'm weird and I want to. I have a Wilson NYX one and a BH Cosmetics one, and I love this one so much. I love them both. This one is a little bit better in my mind. I have an eye primer, the only one. I was so close on the cream shadows that I used as an eye primer. This is the Essence Eye Hard Color Intensifying Eyeshadow Base. This one right here. Didn't like it that much, will not buy that again. For my eyebrows, I used up 4 items. One of them was a gel, and then 3 of them was a gel pencil. No, an eye pencil. The gel was the Queen of Brows Majestic Brow Mascara from W7. I really, really love this one, but I don't think I can buy it again, even if I wanted to. Very sad about that. Then we have the Benefit Goof Proof Brow Pencil in number 3. Love this one. Can't buy that again though. The other 2 are W7, Stroke of Genius and Twist and Shape Brow Pencils. This is a more micro brow thing, and this is a little bit thicker. I really love both of them, and I will buy them again at some point. The only eyeshadow that I have in like a single form is the Catrice Absolute Eye Color in Eyes Wide Open. Single shadow right here. I also used up some shadows in the Too Faced Chocolate Bar palette, 2 of them. White Chocolate and Strawberry Bon Bon. I have the W7 Eye Dream Shadow Cream Liquid Eyeshadow something in Rose Garden. This is a beautiful cream eyeshadow. Love this one so much. And then we have the NYX Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil in Milk. I have 1 highlighter. It is the W7 Strobe and Go Strobing Stick. At least in a single compact form. This was a cream highlighter. It is a beautiful one. I am working on the other one right now. And I finished up a pan of highlighter in the Gwen Stefani Urban Decay Collab Face Palette. And a bronzer from the same palette. So I did use up those 2, but I don't have them here because I didn't finish off the palette. But I did finish a highlighter and a bronzer beside that. I have 4 eyeliners. 2 of them are liquids. W7 Line to 5 eyeliner and the NYX Vivid Bright eyeliner in Vivid Purple. I will not buy these two again. They're both pencils that you have to sharpen, which I don't like. A P2 burgundy one and then a black gouache eyeliner. Oh, I forgot this one. This is a cream shadow in Millie, I think. It was a nude cream blush. Did I say shadow? Cream blush from the Bon Jovi Rockstar palette. I finished this one. Very, very happy about this one. I am working on the red one on and off. I really want to focus on it in 2020 to finish it off. A liquid illuminator highlighter thingy is the W7 Glow Guru Illuminating Face Cream. I have this in with my cream and liquid highlighters actually. And this body sculpting body cream. W7 Life's a Beach Body Contour. It's rubbing off. 7 mascaras. One of them is the Maybelline Lash Sensational Lash Multiplying Mascara in Waterproof. I love this mascara, but I can't get it again. I'm really sad about it, but it is really, really, really good if you want a nice waterproof mascara. I have 3 from W7. 2 of them I will buy again. The one that I won't buy again is the W7 Flirty Eyes Fall Lash Effect Mascara. This is not Fall Lash Effect at all, so I would not buy that again. I have the W7 Lashtastic False Liquid Lashes that I absolutely adore. I will buy this again for sure. It's amazing. And then we have the W7 Very Vegan Mascara. I'll buy this again as well. It is really, really, really good. Then we have 3 Noble Nordic Hey Friends mascaras. I love this mascara. I have another one in my stash. I will always have some on hand. They are absolutely amazing and I love them. And I love them so much. I have a lip stain, cheek and lip stain from Imité Makeup. It is the red stain one. It is all gone. Exciting. I can eliminate a category in my makeup inventory. Exciting. I have 2 lip liners. I have a W7 lip twister in champagne. I absolutely love this formula of a lip liner. The color was nice actually. And a little darker nude. And I finished up an eBay lip liner in a nude color as well. Exciting. Hate that one. Lipsticks. I have 1 liquid lipstick. It is the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in Cannes. This lipstick is amazing. I miss it so much. If I can ever buy a lipstick or justify to buy a lipstick again, I will buy that one. I can't get it out, but it is a Mimi Me Lip Glide in Playful Peach, I believe. Very excited to have this done. I hated that one so much. I have 3 lipsticks. I have a mini from Urban Decay. This one, so beautiful. It is the Revolution Lipsticks. It is in Jolted and it is completely gone. This bright pink shade. Then we have the e.l.f. Oh my god, it is all over the place. Oh my god. It is in Fairy Fuchsia. This one right here. The last lipstick I have is my Maybelline Color Sensational Intensilizing Taupe. I absolutely love this color so much. But I can't buy that lipstick again because it's not cruelty free. Story of my life right now. This is a lip scrub from W7. It is the Jelly Crush lip scrub in some orange. Outrageous orange. This one right here. And yes, I do count them in my makeup inventory. I have thought about not doing, but I don't care. I have 3 lip balms. One is a lip oil from Noble Nordic. This is amazing and I already have 1 new one going. Can you say that? I don't think so. I have the Yves Rosé Framboise lip balm. It's a tinted one. Will not buy again. One I will always have on hand. It is the Forever Aloe Lips with Jojoba. I adore this lip balm so much. Oh my god, it is amazing. It is my favorite lip balm of all time. This one saved my lips for sure when I went to the hospital when I got my surgery more than a year ago. Do you guys want an update for that? I promised a 1-year update and I haven't made one yet. Do you want it? Let me know. All we have left is my nail polish. My nail polish. Okay, I have a base coat and I have a big top coat and I have a nail oil treatment. The treatment is from W7. It is the Complete Care 7-in-1. This was crap. I have the Big Shine top coat from W7. It was fine. Yeah, this is done. And then we have my third base coat from Essence. It is the Anti-Split Nail Sealer base coat. This is amazing, but I can't find it. So, I have three mini nail polishes. One is a glitter, and it is this black glitter nail polish from Depend. The other two is also from Depend, so it is a metallic silver and a deep red color. I have a black nail polish from Essie. It is Licorice. I will not buy this again. I have an e.l.f. nail polish in smoky brown. If I could, I would buy e.l.f. nail polish again. It is amazing. And the last item I have to talk about in this video is the Catrice Luxury Nude Satin Shine nail polish in Delight in Pure Light. This nail polish is amazing. It is beautiful and I love it. I can't buy this again. We don't retail Catrice in Denmark, but I can't get it in Germany, I think. Not this one, but Catrice nail polish. I hope you guys enjoyed this makeup empties for 2019. I'm so excited for 2020 and to see what I can do. I hopefully have more empties and more eyeshadow empties. I really want to have more empties for my eyeshadows. I hit pan on a lot, but I didn't finish a lot. So that is really disappointing. I really want to be better. So I hope you guys enjoyed. And until my next video, please take care. And I hope you are going to stay tuned next year for new project plans that I'm starting. Just filmed a few. I hope you guys enjoyed. And I see you later in another video. Bye.